उत्तम अर्थम स्वयं आत्मनि प्रतिपयुक्ति क्रिया आवय तेन पराभूवत् संशयादिरहितं तत्वनिगमः भविष्यति। अगेन इमं उक्तं अर्थं स्वयं आत्मनि प्रतिपयुक्तिभिः क्रिया आवय तेन पराभूवत् संशयादिरहितं तत्वनिगमः भविष्यति।
इमं उक्तम अर्थम, दिस अर्थ हियर मीनिंग मीन्स दैट इम्प्लीकेशन पुराण सीन, दिस इज नॉट स्मरण, दिस इज नॉट रिमेंबरिंग सिंपली दोज वर्ड्स, इट इज नॉट जप। द वर्ड विच अनफोल्ड आत्मस्वरूप ऑफ ब्रह्म स्वरूप आर मेड यूज to appreciate the Atma Swarupa in a Shuddha Antakarana Devran what they convey. So that is a Ukta Imam Uktam Artham. What do you do? Swayam Atmani, by one's own effort in Atmani, here Atmani, here is Antakarane, in one's own Antakarana, Swayam Atmani भावय, भावय मीन चिंतय, चिंतय हाउ चिंतय प्रतीत युक्ति भी धिया चिंतय, भावय चिंतय मेडिटेट बाय विद हेल्प ऑफ धिया बुद्धि विच हैज टेकन टू प्रतीत युक्ति। प्रथिता मीन फेमस, अप्रूव्ड, अप्रूव्ड बाय श्रुति, श्रुति सम्मत तर्क, रीजनिंग एक्सेप्टेड बाय श्रुति, नॉट एनी रीजनिंग, सो रीजनिंग बेस्ड ऑन श्रुति, बट दैट मीन दैट माइंड इंटेलेक्ट विच टेक्स टू द रीजनिंग बेस्ड ऑन श्रुति विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस वर्ड with the meaning of that, dwell on what is implied in terms of Atma Swarupa Yuktiri, Bhavaya, contemplate, take to Nididhyasana. Do you know what happens thereby? Tena, by such chintana, such bhavana, so what happens is, करांबुवत् संशयादि रहितं तत्व निगमः भवत् भविष्यति। तत्व निगमः भविष्यति, तत्व निगम, निगम इज निर्णय, एसर्टेनमेंट ऑफ आत्मतत्व ब्रह्म तत्व टेक इट। हाउ एन इलस्ट्रेशन इज गिवन, करांबुवत् संशयादि रहितं, there is also hastamalaka desu, this is karambuvat, ambu means ambu means water, water in your palm or the hand, a glass of water is in your hand, have you got doubt about that water? You are sipped also, otherwise it can be it can be you are sipped also, that's what you have no doubt about that, samshayadi rahitam, no doubt whatsoever what Atmaswarupa is, Brahma Swarupa is, all wrong notions are dispelled. So karambuvat, like the water in the hand, so free from doubts and vagueness, so tattva nigama, tattva nirnaya, ascertainment of Atmaswarupa, the Brahma Swarupa is this. So in this manner, what is to be done? See, this will work provided proper exposure to Atmanatma Viveka is there, not sufficient, What is required? Shuddha antakaram. Shuddha antakaram. So that shuddha antakarana gives the disposition for the antakarana to be just like the Swarupa. These words, they serve as coal wash. Actually, they are like, you know that coal wash, jumping high as such. You run, plant it, lift yourself and then walk. Jump on the other side, but don't take the pole out. Push the pole behind and without touching the bar, jump it. So that is why here you should not touch to any drishya. Any drishya adhyasa you should not touch. Any drishya pratyaya kreem, vijatiya pratyaya kreem, out. Last time we have seen Nididhyasana. What are the definition of Nididhyasana according to Vedanta Sara? Sajat Vijatiya Deha Pratyaya Rahita Advitiya Vastu Sajatiya Pratyaya Pravaha. What is the Vijatiya Deha Pratyaya? Any thought of Drishya Jagat beginning from the body. Why? Because if that thought comes, Chaitanya Rupa Atma gets qualified by that thought, it is not the Swarupa of Atma. So these principles must be very good. Even if we have not been able to discover, but be clear about the principle as such. Just Vedanta, 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 a lot of things go on as such. Be clear, because at least one day you know what is required as such. Why I am not able to progress? You yourself will be able to diagnose, etc. Otherwise, 30 years I am exposing to Vedanta, kuch nahi hota hai, guarantee kuch nahi hoga. So that is what is happening. So that disposition must be there. This karambuvat. So like the water in the hand, you have no doubt about that it is the water, so the Atma Swarupa becomes very clear. Continue. That means in this manner, what should be done? The appreciation of Atma Swarupa to the exclusion of Vijatiya cognition. Whatever that is anatma, that should be outside the purview, that is slowly now brings in.
Bodhamatam parishuddha tattvam.
Bodhamatam parishuddha tattvam.
Vijnaya sanghe dukavaccha sainye.
Vijnaya sanghe dukavaccha sainye.
Tatatma daivatmani sarvatasthita.
Tatatma daivatmani sarvatasthita.
Vilapaya brahmani dushyajatam. Saine rupavat cha sanghe svam bodhamatram parishuddha tattvam vijnaya tadatmana eva atmani sarvata sthitaha Drushya jatam brahmani vilapaya. Again, saine dubhavaccha sanghe svam bodhamatram parishuddha tattvam vijnaya tadatmana eva atmani sarvada sthitaha drushya jatam brahmani.
Make your mind absorbed in the Swarupa by directly cognizing the Atma, which is so prominently available in this Karyakarana Sanghata. In the body mind assembly complex of ours, the Atma, which you can never miss, appreciate that, for which an illustration is given. Saine Drupavacha. In an army, king can be identified easily. Why? So there will be a dhvaja, there will be umbrella, etc. Paraphernalia will be there or not. Or in a herd of cattle, a bull can be distinguished. Outstand. So this king is better. In an army, the king outstands. Because some paraphernalia is there. You can make it, oh, there is the king. Like that, in our this assembly of gross body, subtle body, and causal body, what is that outstanding? What is that very glaringly available? Because of which this body is the body, otherwise it would have been Shava. It is Shiva now. It is Shiva now. If that factor misses, it is Shava. Nobody will allow to come near. See, you know, near temple there are some vendor shops. Fruits, that is the garland, flowers, etc., etc. And people who go to temple say, there are chappals at town. I keep my chappals here. Ah, yes, it doesn't matter. But he gets a customer also. It doesn't matter. Suppose a funeral procession was going on. And it started raining cats and dogs. And he said, can we wait here for 5 minutes? Get lost. They will not allow to come anywhere near. Why? Shava. See, at least chappal has smell you. They say, okay, keep it. Doesn't matter. But body is so silly as such. I will say, what is this thing? We say life. Life is what? Manifestation of Atma is not available. So who is missing now? Literally Atma cannot miss, all pervasive. But its availability as Sachetana Swarupa is missing in the body, and therefore now who is the one who outstands in the body? Chaitanya Swarupa Atma. Without which this body is Shava. Is a dead mass. So therefore Saine Nripavat Sanghe. Sanghe means Shariradi Sanghati. In the Karya Karana Sanghata. In the assembly, the gross body, subtle body, and causal body. So Sanghati. That principle, what is that? Subham bodhamatram parishuddha tattvam vijnaya sakshakritya, having directly known. That principle, what is that principle? Svam, oneself, bodhamatram, only bodha. What is that bodha? Only knowledge principle. Only, what that matra means, only, what does it mean? Drishya rahita, anatma pratyaya rahita, free from cognition of anatma pratyaya, free from any anatma cognition. So that was it. So that is, swabodha matram, itself is what? Parishuddha tattvam. Free from sorrow, free from jagat. Jagat is the mala, ashuddhi. Free from that, parishuddha matram, parishuddha tattvam, vijnaya, sakshatkritya. So what do you do? तदात्मना एव सर्वदा आत्मनि स्थितः। तदात्मना, तदात्मना मीन्स व्हाट? आत्मस्वरूपेण इन द नेचर ऑफ वन सेल्फ, आत्मनि इन वन ओन सेल्फ सर्वदा स्थितः, ऑलवेज अबाइडिंग, ऑलवेज अबाइडिंग। व्हाट डू यू डू? दृश्य जातम ब्रह्मणि विलापय। लास्ट टाइम वी हैड सीन दिस इन डिफरेंट कॉन्टेक्स्ट। दृश्य जातम, दृश्य समूह, व्हाट इज दृश्य? ऑल दैट इज नोन एज दिस इन कॉन्ट्रास्ट टू आई, ट्रू आई, ऑल दैट इज नोन एज दिस। सो दृश्य समूह ब्रह्मणि प्रविलापय, मेक इट मर इन ब्रह्म, रिटेनिंग ओनली द कॉग्निशन ऑफ ब्रह्म आत्म। लास्ट टाइम आई हैड सीन अ डाउट इन निधिध्यासन, व्हाई डू यू नीड द एब्सेंस ऑफ फ्रीडम फ्रॉम विजातीय प्रत्यय? What are the definition? विजातीय देहादि प्रत्यय रहित, रहित फ्री फ्रॉम विजातीय बॉडी एटेटा प्रत्यय। वी हैव सीन अ क्वेश्चन, व्हाई इज इट सो? बिकॉज सर्वम ब्रह्म, एवरीथिंग इज व्हाट? ब्रह्म। दिस एवरीथिंग इज ब्रह्म इज नॉट मेंट टू कन्फर ए स्टेटस ऑफ निर्विकारी ब्रह्म ऑन विकारी जगत। व्हाट इज द पर्पस? एट वन प्लेस इन सूत्र भाष्य 131 ब्रह्म सूत्र भाष्य, भाष्यकार से सर्वं ब्रह्म इति सामानाधिकरण्य। दिस इक्वेशन एवरीथिंग मीन्स व्हाट? एंटायर जगत इज ब्रह्म। This equation is with a purpose. What is that purpose? Prapancha pravilapanartham. This jagat is false, like a snake seen on the rope. That jagat has no existence apart from Brahma. But jagat is not nirvikari Brahma. Prapancha pravilapanartham. To dissolve, resolve, merge the jagat in what? Brahma. Just that by appreciating, directly seeing the rope, you merge the snake in the, you know what type of merging, what type of dissolution. There is no snake. What you appreciate is rope. That is why what is necessary? Sajatiya pratyaya vijatiya pratyaya rahityam is very important. Otherwise, everything is Brahma. Why you want to, that is vijatiya pratyaya, why you want to get rid of vijatiya pratyaya? That also in Brahma. It's not that way. You should know. Otherwise, what happens to them? Otherwise, are we not appreciating Atma in and through our all experiences? Any knowledge, any experience is the basis of what? Chaitanya Rupa Atma. But it is not a Yatharta Jnana. Why not Yatharta Jnana? Qualified by Krishna. True knowledge. Knowledge is always true to the thing to be known. Direct knowledge. Not inferential, etc. Direct knowledge is always true to the nature of the thing. It is true to the nature of the thing. Now, Atma is Savishesha or Nirvishesha? Atma Brahma is Drishya Sahita or Drishya Rahita? Then that cognition also must be what? Drishya Rahita. So that is what? So that should be, this is, otherwise, it should be unqualified Atma. Atma unqualified by Drishya Jata. So that is how it is. That is why it should be done. So otherwise that equation is for different purpose. Everything is Brahma. In the sense, jagat has no existence apart from Brahma. To know Brahma, do the pravilapana of this. That's what it says there. ब्रह्म दृश्य जातम ब्रह्मणि विलापय कंटिन्यू
क्षम our swarupa gets conceived
Here, at this level of guha, but because of prominence of vijnanamaya kosha, buddhi guhayam is spoken. Buddhav guhayam, Brahma is there. What Brahma is there? Sadasad vilakshanam. Vilakshanam from sat and because the moment you are told in buddhi guha, Brahma is there, neurosurgeon will be ready. Ready to open the skull, and this journalist will be ready with powerful cameras also, right? To take a snapshot of Brahma. And they can flash, see Brahma. Such and such did the surgery and took the photograph of Brahma. Dangerous. They will find out who is doing Vedanta. Market. Others will not in this. Only those who study Vedanta will say. Garbhar Vajaya can go pretty will say. So, otherwise, say, do you know? For so many years, I am studying Vedanta, etc. I read a story. See, a kingdom, small kingdom was there, and everybody was intelligent. And they used to call them Brahma Jnani. One thing good about this was, including the king, nobody used to fall ill. One vaidya, a doctor, a young doctor, wanted a profession. So he was going from place to place where, what is that? Patient Tuesday, another. He landed in this kingdom. And he was very happy. There is no vaidya. There is no other doctor. But the free hand. I said, but when he interacted with all the people, so he found that, so they were claiming, and it was true, nobody was sick. But these people are telling, see, we are Brahma Jnani. They were claiming, we are Brahma Jnani. No disease can touch. You are wasting your time here. Better find out other. Because you want to find some other place. But he stood to his ground. He said, this will end. And to his luck as it will, king fell ill. King was just readily. Why is it not? He did not hunt for in some other kingdom. He was summoned. He was a good vaidya, a good doctor. He was diagnosed and gave the therapy. And the king was slowly recovering. One day, the king called away, doctor, your medicine is certainly working. But look, it is very slow. Progress is very slow. I am not used to lying down like this. So give me some medicine, okay? Fast recovery. The vaidya thought, this is the time to teach a lesson to all these people. Oh Maharaj, I have got certainly a very quick medicine. But I am afraid I won't get the samagris for it. Material requirement. The king said, what? I can give you anything, you just spell out. In my kingdom, anybody will do anything for my sake. If that is the case, I will dare to tell you. All that I want is half a pound flesh of a Brahma. I want half a pound flesh of a Brahma. Oh, that is the king. All I want in my kingdom is Brahma. So he said, he called a minister. I said, immediately get half a pound of flesh from Brahma. And he went and told all the people that we are not Brahma. How can you be Brahma? We do. So, and king is waiting. He thought it will be available just like that. It will be available. So, the evening over, sunset was over, and late night, the poor minister came with all long face. He said, "Where is the flesh?" "Maharaj, nobody can answer that to me, Brahmajnani." So then where is the pitiable spirit in Sattu who looked at the Vaidya? The Vaidya said, "Maharaj, don't worry, I don't need the flesh, but I wanted to bring to your notice, nobody is a Samsatyani here, as you are already all right now, there is no more necessity of the medicine." So like that, it is not like that Brahma, Jnana, etc. So that direct cognition must be there, otherwise, this is that. Paroksha Jnana, yes. Paroksha Jnana. But certain disposition and the direct discovery is necessary. So that sadasat vilakshanam, distinct from sadasat, otherwise they will be with a surgery camera, they will be ready to find a buddhi worm, and they know buddhi worm is intellect, that much so, and intellect is that the skull, that also they might know. So they will do that. No, it is sat asat vilakshanam. Distinct from sat means murta, that it has got part. Distinct from asat, amurta, that it is formless. Distinct from that. So that param advitiyam. Param. Desha, kala, vastu, aparichinnam. Advitiyam. Sajatiya, vijatiya, swagata, veda, rahitam. It is most exalted, the very basis of entire creation. Non-dual, in reality, there is nothing other than Satya. Satyam trikala abadhita vastu. Satyam Brahma asti. Brahma asti. So Satya Brahma. This is yaha sadatmana atra guhayam vase. The one who tadatmana, tadatmana means brahmatmana, brahma swarupena, guhayam vaset means in one's own antakarna buddhi, one who is able to directly cognize the brahma swarupa. So guha, or here, now it's thrice guha word has come here. First guha we have seen, buddhi guha, which is for all pancha kosha. Now guhaya, in this guha, means in this embodiment, who dwells in this embodiment, tadatmana, brahmatmana, brahma, swarupena, vaset guhayam, remain for him, anga. Anga is a vocative particle. It is like this. It is addressed to Shishya. Well, sir, or it can mean indeed. Anga. Well, sir, well, or indeed. The vocative. Draw the attention of Shishya. Anga, or dear. So that's Anga. Tasya, for such a person, he says, unaha. Guha praveshaha na. For him, no more entry in the guha. Two meanings can be taken. What is guha pravesha is not there. That person will no more take birth. So he will not enter the womb of the mother. No more rebirth. So, guha pravesha means no more taking the embodiment birth. Or guha pravesha can be he has no longer identification with the embodiment. He has no longer identification with the embodiment. In this manner, this Brahma abiding in our own Buddhi Guha should be directly known, thereby no river, moksha is made. Now we are entering into a very important topic. Because one phase of teaching is over. If you take the second verse, what all things are going to be talked, discussed, was listed by the author. There it was told, Atma Anatma Vivechanam, last two lines, second verse. Atma Anatma, second verse. Atmanatma Vivechanam means Atmanatma Vivechanam. Svanubhava, Svasya Anubhava, Svanubhava Vajra. These two topics have been taught so far. Now, author is proceeding to unfold the next topic, that is Brahmatmana Samsthitihi Moksha Mukti. Brahmatmana Samsthitihi Mukti. This is the third topic after Atmana Atma Viveka and Svanubhava told in the this second verse of this text. What is that moksha defined as what? Brahmatmana samsthiti, abidance of Atma in the nature of Brahma. What is that? So that is now being described.
Yate vastunyami bhagavati vasana adiresha.
Again, vastuni nyate
अपि एषा दृढ़ा बलवती अहम् कर्ता अपि भोक्ता इति अनादि वासना अनादि वासना एषा या अस्य संसार हेतु सा सत्यकृष्ट्या आत्मनि निवसता प्रयत्ना आपनेया आपनेया मुनयः यत् वासना नाहव इह मुक्ति प्राहुः।
This stanza to be understand is we should know few things very clearly. Lot of confusion and misunderstanding is going on in Vedanta because of certain topics in this context. First thing, what is vasana is not understood properly. Number two, what is vasana akshaya, here referred as vasana tanava, vasana akshaya, exhaustion of vasana. What is meant by that? What is the role of that? Why it is necessary? That is not known. All this because mukti word is not properly taken to in the proper context. Mukti means what? Moksha. Moksha means what? Liberation. But in Shastra, mukti word is used in two meanings. You have to find out the context and determine what is the meaning. Mukti is not certainly liberation, but there are two aspects of that. What is that? Jivan mukti, videha mukti. I am telling because lot of confusion is going on, and generally in the most of the Vedantic teaching, this topic is sidetracked. And if at all taken, wrong notions are prevailing yourself. So, mukti word is either used in the jivan mukti or in the sense of videya mukti. Again, jivan mukti. All that they say, jivan api muktaha. Liberated while living. That's the end of it. See, therefore, all these should be known properly. Mukti, you know, two ways. One is, let us take first Videha Mukti. First Videha Mukti. What is Videha Mukti? A person who has got Aparoksha Jnana, Aparoksha Brahma Jnana, after the Prarabdha is over, he dies, he has no more rebirth, he is freed from samsara. Generally, this is the concept of moksha. It is true as far as videha mukti is concerned. It is so. It is so. But there is a lot of difference as far as jivan mukti is concerned. Here, they just go wrong or they don't know anything. What is this jivan mukti? This Brahma Jnana cannot give Jivan Mukti. Mere Brahma Jnana cannot give Jivan Mukti. Mere Brahma Jnana certainly guarantees Vidya Mukti. Very important thing. Mere Brahma Jnana doesn't give Jivan Mukti. What is necessary for Jivan Mukti? Before that, we should know what is Jivan Mukti. Jivan, any living being has got a mind or not? Don't say never mind. has got a mind or not. What are the gunadharmas of the mind? What are the gunadharmas of the mind? What are the characteristics of the mind? So what does it do? See, the features of the mind or the characteristics of the mind are called as chitta dharma. They are called as what? Chitta dharma. They comprise in terms of notion that this body is me. The notion, whatever that is done by the body, I am the doer, kartrutva. The notion, whatever that is experienced body, I am the bhokta, bhoktrutva. Then joy, sorrow, anger, grief, desire, host of all this. This is mine, this is not mine. Or do you know what these chitta dharmas do? These chitta dharmas breed chitta klesha, afflictions, anguish in the mind. You may wonder, that is fine, but once the Brahma Jnana is gained, chitta kleshas will vanish? Certainly not. To get rid of chitta kleshas, two further sadhanas are necessary. They are vasana kshaya, mano nasha. What about Atma Jnana, Brahma Jnana? That is Tattva Jnana, that also is necessary. So therefore, for Jivan Mukti, what is necessary? Tattva Jnana, there is no escape from that, Brahma Jnana. Then, Mano Nasha, Vasana Kshaya. When these three are gained, Jivan Mukti is guaranteed. And for Videha Mukti, you need not bother about Vasanakshaya and Manonasha. Mere Tattva Jnana guarantees Videha Mukti. For Madhu, Jivan Mukti, Tattva Jnana is necessary, but more prominent are Vasanakshaya and Manonasha. Why? Chitta kleshas are to be subdued. What is this? So therefore, for Jivan Mukti, what all things are necessary? Three. Tattva Jnana means Atma Jnana, Brahma Jnana, Mano Nasha, Vasana Kshaya. Now in this sense, in Shastra, depending on the context, at certain places, certain of the, one of the three or more than one are highlighted. If Videha Mukti, Tattva Jnana, no other book, Tattva Jnana. Jivan Mukti, Tattva Jnana, Vasanakshaya and Manonasha. But while dealing in a particular context, depending on the student, at places Vasanakshaya may be extolled. At other places, Manonasha may be praised. At third places, Brahma Jnana may be highlighted. We have to see the context. Before that, first ascertain, based on context, word mukti used, is it Videha Mukti or Jivan Mukti? If Videha Mukti, Tattva Jnana, but don't bother. But do you know what will happen? This Brahma Jnani, until Prarabdha gets over, he is going to get the thappads of Sukha Dukha. Brahma Jnani is true, but Manonasha, Vasana, Akshaya are not accomplished. He is afflicted by joys and sorrows in the life. Why? Manonasha is not there, Vasana, Akshaya is not there. But for him, Videha Mukti, no appeal. Even Ishvara can't stop it. Guarantee? How? Ishvara also can't stop it. So that is it. So that from that standpoint, that is what here we have to see. That is, what is that here called as vasana tanavam? Movement vasana kshaya manonasha comes. See, that we know for certain context is jivan mukta. Jivan mukta is the one who at will can make the mind withdraw from the world and get absorbed in the swarupa. Chitta klesha, chitta dharma can't do anything for him. Manonasha is like, vasana cannot shake him. Now the question comes, very important, what is vasana? This also is not properly understood. Generally it is said as innate tendency. Yes. But what you mean by innate tendency? In this modern age of computer science, you can say vasana constitute the software of the individual. It is the software of the individual in the hardware of the gross body. Where situated in that which CPU? In the mind CPU it is situated. So now you have to know now what is this vasana. I think I will take it next time, freshest, very important. See, look, in short I will tell you, vasana means, look here, do we not take the body as I? Which KG class we have gone? To know that I am the body. Did parents tell you? They may say, kiddo, kiddo. Like that, Tommy, kiddo, he was other, kiddo, kiddo, kiddo. Because they point out, kiddo, 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 kiddo. Who taught you? Huh? That at least by practice you may say. See, the baby monkey, who taught it should lack the mother? Who told the just newly born infant that has to cry when he is hungry? Who taught all these things? So, there was programmed or not? That program is what? Vasana. This is mine. This is thine. You get angry. Do you see? Spontaneous desire comes. Means without thinking the past and the future. Spontaneously you react, that is that substance is vasana. That is what is the vasana. Vasana determines the individual. So we will see what are the types of vasana. In more detail I will give you the definition of vasana and how many types. So this is very important because Jivan Mukti Viveka is a much neglected text and much misunderstood text in Veda. So much neglected text and much misunderstood from Vedanta. In fact, it is Jivan Mukti Viveka is written by Vidyaranyamani. Vidyaranyamani. So that is that. Otherwise, you know what happens? These topics of Vasanakshaya or Manuanasha or Tattva Jnana create lot of confusion. When I was teaching Yoga Vasishtha, even now I am teaching Yoga Vasishtha, I say, if you want to enter into Yoga Vasishtha, first have the sound key of Jivan Mukti. if one has not mastered jivan mukti viveka, yoga vasishtha can be a tough test, very difficult to, that means, understand that. Because all Vidyarangamuni analytically has established in jivan mukti. In fact, jivan mukti viveka, a lot of bhaktis are from yoga vasishtha only. All verses are there, but systematically he has established the rule of Brahmajnanam, Vasanakshaya, Manonakshaya in the context of Vidya Mukti. Brahmajnana, Tattvajnana is common. In the context of Jivan Mukti, no doubt Tattvajnana, Brahmajnana is necessary, but more prominent is what? Vasanakshaya, Manonakshaya. Next time we will see in little more detail the definition of vasana, how many types of vasana are there. So what are the means of tattvajnana, what are the sadhanas of vasanakshaya, what are the sadhanas of manonakshaya, all these things. Because if that is clear now, in fact, some people have labeled that Vivek Chudamani book is not written by Adi Shankaracharya because it speaks of Vasanakshaya. But my dear sir, Vasanakshaya, Manonakshaya is a topic from many Upanishads. It may not be in the 10 or 11, 12 Upanishads generally studied, it may not be. But if you see Upanishad, this is the common thing. In fact, in Vivek Chudamani, from this Upanishad, verbatim verses are quoted. In fact, I have somewhere noted, more than 100 verses can be found from this Upanishad in this Vivek Chudamani. More than 100 verses can be found from different Upanishads. I have noted that somewhere. So this Vasanakshaya, Manonakshaya also will come. Tattvajnana. Rule should be known very clearly, and you should know what the Jivan Mukti is in contrast to Vidya Mukti. All confusion comes, you know, they take wherever Jivan Mukti is that Vidya Mukti, and Jivan Mukti generally is Jivan Mukti Mukta Kam Ho Gaya. So that is over. So that's all confusing. You should know what is what very clearly. In fact, I decided to take Vivek Chudamani. I have taught Vivek Chudamani in the past. Because to resolve this confusion. So when I took, I myself had not gone in depth of Jivan Mukti Vivek. Now I know what is, I have got the key, and therefore I said I have to teach Vivek Chudamani once again so that proper teaching will be recorded. It will be useful for prosperity. Even one person makes use, I am happy. It is not for commercial purpose. Even one person really knows what the truth is and he comes to know, I am very happy about that. Oh.